क्लास 12 अकाउंटेंसी चैप्टर इश्यू ऑफ डिबेंचर। वेलकम बैक ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न ऑल द जर्नल एंट्रीज ऑफ दिस चैप्टर इश्यू ऑफ डिबेंचर। आई विल ट्राई टू कवर ऑल द जर्नल एंट्रीज विथ इट्स एक्सप्लेनेशन एंड इन माई नेक्स्ट वीडियो वी विल टेक सम एक्सरसाइज ऑल्सो सो दैट यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड इट। सो लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड ऑल द एंट्रीज कवर्ड इन दिस चैप्टर। Myself Kishore Chauhan and I welcome all of you on my YouTube channel Guru of Accountancy. First of all, what is debenture? So you all know debenture is a written instrument acknowledging a debt under the common seal of the company. Debenture holders are the creditors of the company. When company collect fund from public by issuing debenture, it issues one instrument acknowledging this debt, and that instrument is known as debenture. The word debenture has been derived from the Latin word deber, which means to borrow. So this you all know. What is bond? So bond is similar to debenture. It is also one instrument acknowledging debt. Normally bonds are issued by the government, but nowadays bonds are also issued by the SEBI government and non-government organizations. So both these terms, debenture and bonds, are used interchangeably. Different types of debenture. Company may issue different kinds of debenture. So the types of debentures can be classified on the basis of security, on the basis of tenure, on the basis of redemption, on the basis of coupon rate and registration. So you can see the chart given here. On the basis of security, debentures are secure debenture and unsecured debenture. On the basis of tenure, they may be redeemable debenture and irredeemable debenture. And on the basis of conversion, redemption, it may be convertible debenture and non-convertible debenture. Based on the coupon rate, zero coupon rate and specific rate. And on the basis of registration, redeemable debenture and bearer debenture. Sorry, there would be correction here. It should be registered debenture and bearer debenture. So these are the different types of debentures. Now debentures can be issued at par, at premium and at discounts. Debentures can also be issued for cash, for consideration other than cash and as a collateral security. So these are the different cases in which we have to go, we have to learn journal entries. So let us take all the point one by one. First point, issue of debentures for cash. And in that, journal entries for the issue of debentures for cash, in that issued at par. Now when debentures are issued at par, they are issued at face value. So when face value of debenture and its issue price both are same, then it is known as debentures are issued at par. Now in this case, if the company collect entire amount in one installment, then what would be the journal entry? So if the whole amount is received in one installment, your entry would be on the receipt of application money, bank account debit to debenture application and allotment account. Thereafter, this money will be transferred to so-and-so percentage debenture account. So, on making allotment, entry would be debenture application and allotment account debit to so-and-so percentage debenture account. So, only these two entry will come when the entire amount is collected in lump sum. That means in one installment. But amount of debenture can also be collected by installment. So if the debenture amount is received in installment, like application, allotment, first call, second call, then your entries would be like this. First is for application money received. So entry would be bank account debit to debenture application account. Thereafter, this application money will be transferred to debenture account. So entry would be debenture application account debit to so-and-so percentage debenture account. So this is a combination of these two entry. First application money received and thereafter it is transferred to debenture account. Thereafter allotment money due and allotment money received. So allotment due, debenture allotment account debit to so and so percentage debenture account. And when the amount is received, entry would be bank account debit to debenture allotment account. So this is the combination of allotment, first due entry, and thereafter receipt entry. Now suppose company has made first and final call. It may be second call also. So entry would be debenture first and final call account debit to so and so percentage debenture account. This is first call money due. And on the receipt of this, we will write bank account debit to debenture first and final call account. So when the amount of debenture is collected in installment, this would be the different entries. Now we are seeing when debentures are issued at discount, where would be the change? So keep in mind, when debentures are issued at discount, then issue price is less than the face value. And in that case, the amount of discount we have to take in the allotment money. That means when the allotment will become due, in that case, we will record the discount. So first, when debenture is issued at a price below its nominal value, that means face value, it is said to be issued at discount. Say for example, the issue of rupees 100 debenture at rupees 95, rupees 5 being amount of discount. 95 is the issue price and 100 is the nominal value. So here in the allotment due entry, you will write entry debenture allotment account debit, discount on issue of debenture account debit to so and so percentage debenture. All other entries will remain same. Only your entry number 3, that means allotment due, will change. In that you will add discount on issue of debenture account. Now this discount on issue of debenture is a capital loss and it must be written off in the year it occurs. So say for example, in 2020-21, if debentures are issued at discount, then in that year only, this discount should be written off from securities premium reserve or from general reserve or from the statement of profit and loss. Next point is journal entries for the issue of debentures for cash, and they are issued at premium. So when issue price is more than the face value, we can say that debentures are issued at premium. Say for example, issue price is 100 of rupees 100 debenture is rupees 110. That means issue price is 110 and face value is 100. So here 10 rupees is amount of premium. This amount of premium is a capital profit and that we have to credit to the securities premium reserve account. Here also, your entry number 3, that is allotment due, will change debenture allotment account debit to so and so percentage debenture account to securities premium reserve account. So discount entry as well as premium entry you have to make in the entry number 3, that means allotment due. Okay, now this securities premium reserve is a capital profit. And this capital profit can be utilized to write off capital losses like preliminary expenses, discount on issue of debentures, premium on redemption of debentures, etc. And in balance sheet, securities premium reserve is shown on equity and liability side under the head reserves and surplus. So these were the entries about the issue of debentures for cash, in that at par, at premium, and at discount. Now we are shifting on the second case, issue of debentures for consideration other than cash. So sometimes a company purchases assets from vendors and instead of making payment in cash, company issues its debenture for consideration. Such issue of debenture is called debenture issued for consideration other than cash. So say for example, XYZ Limited purchased machinery and for that it issued its debenture to the vendor. So it is issue of debentures for consideration other than cash. Here also debentures can be issued at par, at premium, or at discount. So what will be the journal entries in this case? First entry we will pass for the purchase of assets. So your entry would be sundry assets account debit to vendor. Assets come in the business, so it is debited and we are liable to pay to vendor. So it is our liability, so to vendor's account. So this entry will come sundry asset account debit to vendor's account. Thereafter, we will issue debentures. Now, as I told you, debentures can be issued at par, at premium, or at discount. So, if the debentures are issued at par, then entry would be vendor account debit to so-and-so percentage debenture account. Here we are issuing debentures at face value, at nominal value. But if the debentures are issued at premium to vendor, then securities premium reserve account will be credited. So you can see entry is vendor account debit to so-and-so percent debenture account to securities premium reserve account. At many places you will see the securities premium, but now the securities premium reserve word is used. If the debentures are issued at discount, then discount and issue of debenture account will be debited. So vendor account debit, discount and issue of debenture account debit to so-and-so percentage debenture account. So here you can see first entry was for the purchase of asset, sundry assets account debit that you will write individually to vendor. And second entry would be for the issue of debenture. Out of these three, any one entry will come if issued at par, or if it issued at premium, or if it issued at discount, accordingly you have to pass the journal entry. So this is all about journal entries for the issue of debentures for consideration other than cash. Now in this, we are seeing some extra point. Sometime a company may purchase the assets as well as take over its liabilities of another concern. That means not only the assets, but the liabilities are also purchase of another business. When it happens, it usually happens when company purchases the entire business. In such a situation, the purchase consideration will be equal to the value of net asset. What is net asset? Net asset means assets minus liabilities taken over. And the difference of these two is known as purchase consideration. So for example, assets are taken over at 50 lakh and liabilities are 20 lakh. So 50 lakh minus 20 lakh. So purchase consideration would be 30 lakhs. In this case, your entry number one will change. And entry number one for the purchase of asset would be like this: sundry assets account debit to sundry liabilities account to vendor account. Because we are also buying liabilities, so liabilities will be credited. So your entry number one will change slightly because we are purchasing entire business, assets as well as liabilities. In this, there are some extra points are also there. If the whole amount of business is taken over and the amount of debenture issued is more than the amount of net assets taken over, that means purchase consideration, the difference will be treated as goodwill. So in that case, in this entry, goodwill account will be debited. So you can see the same entry is written: sundry assets account debit, goodwill account debit to sundry liabilities to vendor. When it will happen? When debenture issued are more than the purchase consideration. Say for example, purchase consideration is 5 lakh and we have issued the debentures of rupees 6 lakh. So 1 lakh rupees extra we have given for goodwill. We have purchased business, so we are paying extra for the goodwill, and that's why goodwill account will be debited. Reverse case is also possible. We issue the debentures of less amount compared to the purchase consideration. So that would be our profit, capital profit, and that will be transferred to capital reserve. So, but if the value of debenture issued is less than the value of net asset taken over, that means purchase consideration, difference will be credited to capital reserve. So the same entry, you can see sundry assets account debit to sundry liabilities to vendor account, and here two capital reserve is credited because we are here getting capital profit. Say for example, purchase consideration is 5 lakh and you are issuing the debentures of rupees 3 lakh. So here you are getting 2 lakh rupees profit. That's why that 2 lakh rupees will be transferred to capital reserve. As I told you, purchase consideration is the difference of sundry assets minus sundry liabilities. Many times purchase consideration is ready-made given. So that amount you have to write in vendor. Vendor account will be credited with the purchase consideration. If not given, then the difference of sundry assets and sundry liabilities would be considered as purchase consideration. Now we are shifting towards the third point, issue of debentures as a collateral security. Now what is collateral security? So collateral security may be defined as a subsidiary or secondary or additional security issued by company along with primary security when a company obtains a loan or overdraft from bank or any financial institutions. So when you borrow money from bank, then bank asks for security. So say, for example, you have given your plant and machinery as a security, but bank is requesting for additional security. So in addition, we are issuing our company's debenture as a security. So that case is issue of debenture as an additional security. That means as a collateral security. Now here, journal entries. So there are two methods for this. In the first method, we do not pass any journal entry because no liability is created by the issue of debenture. We are just giving debenture as a security. We are not issuing. We are just giving as a security. So no entry is passed. But in the balance sheet, on the equity and liability side, when you prepare the notes in that, below the item of loan, a note that loan has been secured by issue of debenture as a collateral security is shown. So in a note to account, below the amount of loan, you have to write in bracket that this loan is secured by issue of so-and-so number of debentures. So that thing you have to do only. Here no entry, only note is added. So this is the first method. Second method is, in that we pass journal entry. We pass the entry debenture suspense account debit to so-and-so percentage debenture account. Here we have issued debenture as a security. No cash is received. That's why debenture suspense account is debited to debentures account. And in the balance sheet on the equity and liability side, when you prepare the notes, then debenture suspense account will be shown as a deduction from the debenture account. So in notes to account, you have to write so-and-so percentage debenture. From that you will minus debenture suspense. So ultimately amount will be nil in the outer column. Okay, in both this method, you are taking a bank loan. So in both the method, you have to pass one common entry, bank account debit to bank loan for taking the amount of loan, for taking the bank loan. So these are the two methods for the issue of debentures for the as a collateral security. Now, out of this, which method to follow? So that will be given in the question. And if it is not given, you can follow any one method. Okay. Now the next topic is the terms of issue of debentures. When a company issues debentures, it usually mentions the term on which they will be redeemed at their maturity. We know amount of debenture company has to redeem after few years. So how company will redeem? What amount company will give on maturity? So that is term on issue of debenture. Redemption of debenture means repayment of amount of debenture to debenture holder after few years. Debentures can be redeemed at par or at premium. That means on maturity date, company may return face value of the debenture or it may redeem at premium. So depending upon the terms and conditions of the issue of redemption of debenture, following six situations are possible. First point, debentures issued at par and they may be redeemable at par. That means issued at rupees 100 and redeemable also at rupees 100. Issued at discount and redeemable at par. That means debentures are issued at 95 rupees and redeemable at rupees 100. Third, issued at premium and redeemable at par. That means issued at 110 and redeemable at rupees 100. Thereafter, issued at par and redeemable at premium. That means issued at rupees 100 and redeemable at 110. So these are the different cases in which very clearly mentioned that at the time of redemption, what amount will be given back to the debenture holder. So this is known as the terms of issue of debenture. What will be the journal entry? Let us see. First case, issue of debentures at par and redeemable at par. So it is a simple case. In that, first entry would be bank account debit to debenture application allotment account with the face value. Second entry, debenture application account and allotment account debit to so-and-so percentage debenture account. This will be at par because here issued as well as redeemable at par. Second case, issue of debenture at discount and redeemable at par. So here in the issue entry, you have to take care of discount. Discount is a capital loss, so that will be debited. Your first entry would be for bank account debit to debenture application and allotment account. Here you will receive less amount because discount will be cut. So bank account debit to debenture application and allotment account issued at discount. Second entry, debenture application and allotment account debit, discount on issue of debenture account debit to so-and-so percentage debenture account. So these debentures are issued at discount, so discount is debited. So in this both the cases, you can see they are redeemable at par. So there is nothing extra. Already you know this. We have already covered this. Third case, issued debentures at premium and redeemable at par. So here debentures are issued at premium. So securities premium reserve account we will credit. Bank account debit to debenture application allotment account. Here we will receive premium also in first entry. In second entry, debenture application allotment account debit to so-and-so percentage debenture account with the face value to securities premium reserve account because debentures are issued at premium. So we have seen first three cases in which debentures are issued at par, at discount and at premium, but they are redeemable at par. You can see in all the three cases, they are redeemable at par, redeemable at par, redeemable at par. Now, next point. Debentures issued at par, discount and premium, and they are redeemable at premium. So let us see the fourth case. Debenture issued at par, say for 100 rupees and redeemable at premium. That means suppose 110, 10 rupees premium. So 100 rupees collected, but redeemable 110. So first entry, bank account debit to debenture application allotment account. This entry would be with 100 rupees, that is face value because they are issued at par. In the second entry, you have to take care, debenture application and allotment account debit, loss on issue of debenture account debit, because we are redeeming at premium. So this premium which we have to give on maturity is our capital loss. So that is debited. So loss on issue of debenture account will be debited with the redemption premium to so-and-so percentage debenture with the face value, nominal value, and to premium on redemption of debenture account. Premium on redemption of debenture account that we are giving on redemption. This is a different from the securities premium reserve. The word securities premium reserve come when debentures are issued at premium. Here debentures are not issued at premium. They are issued at par, but the premium is of redemption, redemption premium. So that's why premium on redemption of debenture is credited. It is one type of capital loss. Fifth case, debentures issued at discount and redeemable at premium. So here you can see there are two types of losses. One is issued at discount, that is one loss. And second, premium, which we have to give at the time of redemption. So two losses are there here. So your first entry would be bank account debit to debenture application allotment account. In this entry, you will not take the amount of discount. Suppose discount is 5 rupees and face value is 100. So this entry will come with 95 rupees. Bank account debit to debenture application allotment account 95, because we will get only 95, discount is less. In the second entry, you have to take care, debenture application allotment account debit, loss on issue of debenture account debit, it will be debited with the two amount. One is the discount on issue of debenture and second is the redemption premium, which we have to give at the time of redemption. To so-and-so percentage debenture account, always with nominal value, face value, and to premium on redemption of debenture account. This is redemption premium. So you can see here, debentures are issued at discount and redeemed at premium. So there are two types of losses. Both are debited to loss, both are debited in loss on issue of debenture account. The last case is issue of debenture at premium and redeemable at premium. Now here debentures are issued at premium. So when you will receive money, you will receive premium amount also. So your first entry, bank account debit to debenture application and allotment account. So for example, face value is 100 and premium is 10. So this first entry will come with 110 rupees. Second entry, debenture application and allotment account debit, loss on issue of debenture account debit. This is because of redemption premium. To so-and-so percentage debenture account, and here one more point will come to securities premium reserve account. This is the premium on the issue of debenture because these debentures are issued at premium. So securities premium reserve account will be credited. And Last is to premium on the redemption of debenture account, that is premium which we have to give at the time of redemption. So these are the different cases. Total 6 cases we have covered, which is known as terms of issue of debenture. These terms are decided at the time of issue only. So when you pass the journal entry of the issue of such debenture, you have to write any entry of this as the case may be. Now, interest on debenture. When a company issues debenture, it is under an obligation to pay interest at a fixed rate. Normally, interest is paid half yearly. This percentage is usually a part of the name of debenture, like 6% debenture, 8% debenture, 10% debenture. So this percentage indicates rate of interest. Interest is payable and is calculated at a nominal value. Interest is calculated on the nominal value, that means on face value. Interest on debenture is a charge against the profit of a company, and it must be paid whether the company has earned profit or not. So it is a charge against profit. And according to the Income Tax Act 1961, a company must deduct tax, income tax, jisko TDS bolenge, tax deducted at source, from the amount of interest. So if you are getting, suppose 100 rupees interest, from that 10%, that means 10 rupees company will cut for TDS, and that TDS company will give to government. It is called tax deducted at source, and it is deposited with the tax authorities by the company. So when you will get the amount of interest, that will be less of TDS. Already TDS company will cut, and company will deposit that money to government. Now, what will be the journal entries if we have to pass for interest on debenture? So it is a expense. So debenture interest account is debited to income tax, that is TDS payable account credit to debenture holder. This is the due entry. Interest is debited because it is expense, and liability towards income tax department is credited, and liability toward debenture holder is credited. Second entry, for the payment of interest to the debenture holder account debit to bank, interest is paid. Third entry, for the payment of TDS to the government, TDS payable account debit to bank. So these two entries are for the payment of respective amount, either to debenture holder and to government. At last, at the end of the year, you have to remember that interest on debenture we have to transfer to the statement of profit and loss. So your entry would be statement of profit and loss debit to debenture interest. So these are the 4 entries which are passed for the issue of for the interest on debenture. First 3 entries will come 2 times because debenture is paid half yearly. So at the end of first 6 months, first 3 entries will come, and at the end of the year, all these 4 entries will come, because at the end of the year, interest is transferred to statement of profit and loss. Next case is writing off discount or loss on issue of debenture. The discount or loss on issue of debenture is a capital loss to company. So it must be written off in the year in which they occur. Again, I am reading. It must be written off in the year in which they occur. From the securities premium reserve, if it exists, or from general reserve, or from the statement of profit and loss. So in the year of issue only, we will write off this discount or loss on issue of debentures. So your entry would be securities premium reserve account debit, or general reserve account debit, or statement of profit and loss account debit to discount or loss on issue of debenture account. Out of these 3, whatever is available, that you have to utilize. If security premium reserve is available, then you will utilize securities premium reserve. If it is not there, then general reserve. And if it is not there, then finally you have option of statement of profit and loss. So this will be the entry for the writing of discount on issue of debentures. So dear students, in this we have taken all the journal entries of this chapter. I hope this would be very helpful session for you. Watch this video again and again and revise your journal entries. You can also find some videos on the exercise of this chapter, in that I have tried to explain you exercise on all this concept. Go through this. Please subscribe to my channel and like this video. Thank you. Bye bye. Tata.